There's something about living in a desert that makes you so happy about rain. Maybe it's that we get so little that we can really appreciate it. It could be that smell before the rain hits.
I smell rain.
If you're from Arizona, you know. And these are probably the only moments that my climate anxiety isn't turned up to 10. And I forget about what's happening with water in Arizona.
The water supply from the biggest reservoir in America is drying up.
Because when I see stories about Lake Mead or the mega drought, I just feel like maybe the end of the world is coming. I usually deal with it through avoidance, denial, but ultimately I'm lucky enough to ask ASU experts because I work here. So here are some of my anxiety-fueled questions. The biggest one on my mind, on everybody's mind, is when does the water run out?
We won't run out, but certain industries and certain fields will decline more precipitously than others.
He's talking about agriculture. They're facing the biggest cuts in Arizona, mostly because they're the largest water user in our state, at 72% compared to cities and industry. We just won't have enough quantity to support some types of agriculture in the future. So let's say Arizona cuts its water for agriculture, which it's already done, but there's still problems that come with a reduced water flow.
Quantity is always the main focus. But quality is adding this new dimension of risk that cannot basically be ignored entirely. But how do we come to grips with it?
Our systems were made to deliver water to fields, not cities. Canals are open to the elements, and the work that Taylor does is around algae and cyanobacteria. He works on the detection of algae blooms that might pop up anywhere along the over 300 miles of cap canals that deliver water in our desert. Cities then have to clean the algae out of our water along with silt and dirt. So it's a lot, but this is Sarah, and she made me feel a lot better because Arizona has always been planning for a future with less water.
It's not helpful to scare people, especially in central Arizona, where we have these regulations that have ensured that for the vast majority of people, there is a long-term water supply. A misunderstanding is that population growth is the cause of our shortage issues.
Okay, now for another dumb question. Is this my fault? Am I showering too much? Am I wasting water? Should I even be living in the desert?
Like, if your natural impulse is, it feels like it's more water than should be used. It's a waste of water. I think that's good. That's the culture we need to have. You know, we have to be feeling like this water is precious.
So I asked Sarah about some of my favorite things and to give them a thumbs up or down. And she was pretty nice about it.
Watering my indoor plants, I have 100.
100? Wow, that's a lot of water. I'd say that's fine. That's fine.
Slip and slide in the backyard.
That is, how often do you do it?
Let's say once a month.
It's probably okay. Yeah, this wouldn't be like my first choice.
My parents have a backyard pool.
Yeah, now pools use a lot of water
because they're losing that water through evaporation. So you should definitely get a cover to seal your pool.
The very best thing is to get rid of the pool.
Car washing once.
Car wash at a car wash is better than washing in your
Basically,
yard.
Basically, we want the water to go back down the drain. 93% of that water is going to be reused and recycled by the city.
And all of these things, you know, they're a choice about how to use water.
I could tell she felt conflicted about this one because golf brings tourism and a lot of golf courses can also be outdoor green spaces that we use for walking or jogging.
By the same token, a water-intensive industry that no one ever brings up is craft beer. And, you know, like, we're not allowed to talk about craft beer because we love it. But as for golf courses, I think we will probably see some golf courses retire.
Of course, there has to be solutions to increase our water supplies, right?
And there are I can go through a whole litany of engineering, you know, technical solutions that will bring more water.
This makes me feel better. To sum it up, one, we could lease water from the Colorado River Indian tribes. They're looking to lease about 93,000 acre feet of water, and this would be equivalent to the annual usage of 186,000 homes in the valley. Number two and three are part of the Salt River Project. They've proposed enlarging Bartlett Dam and to retire Horseshoe Dam, which is prone to sedimentation. Additionally, they believe Roosevelt Dam could be allowed to fill a bit higher, and that water could be stored in aquifers for future use. Number four, the Harquahala Basin in La Paz County. It's brackish or salty water that could be pumped and cleaned, and its proximity to our cap canals would mean much easier delivery. Last but not least, number five, desalination, but not in California. See, Mexico has a right to the Colorado River water, and Arizona has been working on the idea of building and funding a desalination plant in Mexico in exchange for their Colorado River water. Okay, I'm feeling a little bit better. Still anxious. But do the experts feel anxious?
So I don't feel anxiety about it because I know solutions are available. If I have anxiety, it's about the will to implement those solutions.
I have a pretty high degree of confidence, especially in central Arizona cities, in continuing to meet demand and stay very water resilient.
So if they don't feel anxiety, why do I? This is Lonnie. She studies our emotions and the neurology behind them.
We're anxious about climate change because we should be anxious about climate change. So the real question is, how do we go from anxiety, which is paralyzing, to, okay, I know what to do and I'm gonna do that. And that tends to help alleviate the anxiety and convert that same awareness of the situation into a more proactive stance.
So maybe I can take the anxiety to fuel my actions. I'll be considering water policy at my state and local level. I'll consider the amount of water used to produce the products that I buy. And I'll be rethinking my 100 plants. 96 is probably enough.